Hi, I'm Debbie Shaw, and I'd like to tell you a little bit about my Half Yard Sewing Club. It's an online subscription website which launched in 2018 in August and boasts almost 1,500 members worldwide. It's a lovely community. We've got some really interactive members and you're getting an awful lot for your money as well. So I'll talk you through just a few of the projects that we've been bringing you over the last 14, 15 months. So basically, every single month you will receive a main project. This will be downloadable, and the reason for them being downloadable is that it can be worldwide, so there's no shipping to pay to post anything out. And that project can be a bag, it could be a quilt, it could be a table runner, it could be a soft toy, it could be homewares, evening wares. There's so many different genres of sewing, and I try to bring you something different every single month. With that project, you will have a video, you will have step-by-step instructions with photographs, and you will have a pattern. That's not all you get though, because there's also a secondary project that doesn't have the video. That may be a technique like weaving ribbon and making handbags out of it. It may be a smaller quilt, it may be a set of coasters, it may be a no-sew skirt or top. That again is going to vary from month to month. And we don't finish there, because on top of all of that, we're also going to give you discounts, special offers. Just in the last 12 months alone, we've given away over 100 different products for you. And you get discounts on anything from books from the Search Press website, you'll get 20% off there, to fabric discounts as well. So you can see there's an awful lot of benefits, there's an awful lot of reasons for you to be there. If you want to have a quick look, it's the Half Yard Sewing Club. So go to www.halfyardsewingclub.com, and there you'll see an overview of what the whole site's about. We have an Ask a Member area, so if you have any questions or you want to get interactive with other club members, then you can do, and I'll chip in there as well. We also do a live Facebook chat once a month, and it's normally the last Wednesday in the month, where you can ask your questions to me, and we'll do a bit of sewing and we'll do a bit of demonstration there as well. So you can see it's absolutely jam-packed full. Now, if you are a complete beginner sewer, this is a great place to be, because any one of these projects that you're looking at, and that could be new techniques like applique on homeware, so that's your mug hug and mug rug hug, you know the things. There's also oven mitts to go with those. I'll break it down so that even as a complete beginner, you're going to understand the way that these things work. And again, you can sew along with me. You've got the real-time videos there as well. If you're a little bit more advanced, there are going to be techniques for you as well. And you can take any of these ideas and improve them, and change them, make them your very own. This is actually a request from one of the club members. I made a rabbit, and somebody came along and said, oh, could you do an elephant? And somebody else said, can you do a cat? So you know what, you get what you ask for. So we changed this and we added that it's a drawstring bag, so you can actually keep pajamas and things like that in it. So it is purposeful as well. And you can resize it if you wanted to make it bigger and make it into a pajama bag or something like that. And it hangs up at the back, so you can hang it on the back of the door. But then the heads are interchangeable. Another thing that you asked for, whoops, was the wheelchair bag. Now this one has a detachable strap, and you've been making these up already, so that you can carry it, or you can use the tabs at the side over the handles of your wheelchair. They happen to be the same distance as the handles on the average push chair, and you don't have to have the detachable handle. So although the request was for a wheelchair bag, not everybody's in a wheelchair, so a lot of you are using these as overnight bags. It's got a nice secret zip pocket in the front of the flap, and it's got a divider in the centre there as well, with another zip pocket on the inside. I've seen some of these that you've made up already, and you're doing such a good job of them. And I was actually talking at a show, I was at a Harrogate show last month, and a lady came over to me in her wheelchair, and she said, thank you so much for making a bag that had the detachable strap, because when her boyfriend's pushing her around, he wants to take the bag off and carry it at some point, and bags that only have the short straps, you can't do that with. The man bag, that was a request as well, but again, we're not all men. So with this one, you can make it in manly colours, you could make it in pretty colours. Basically, it's a messenger bag, but it does have pockets on the back as well. So you get an idea now of the kind of things that you can take advantage of, that you can enjoy when you're with the club. And I've got even better news for you as well, because if you join now, You're going to get all of these projects for the last 12 months for free for a whole month. And on top of that, if you write the code SQDebbie in capital letters as you go through to checkout, I'm going to send you a book. I'm going to send you a copy of my Half Yard Vintage book. And that's anybody that joins up right now. Now, when you go through to the website, you will need to leave all of your details and you will need to leave your credit card details. That's just the way that the website has been set up. So if you go to halfyardsewingclub.com, go to join now, fill in all of your details. You won't be charged. Put SQ Debbie in capital letters into the appropriate section. And then you're there. You can take advantage of all of these projects for like a back catalogue of a whole year. So SQ Debbie, capital letters, you get your free book. Now then, I just want to show you really quick. We're going to do some sewing in a second, but I just wanted to show you these because also on top of everything that I've just told you about, we do a block of the month. So this is the 2019 block of the month. A lot of you have completed this already. Lots of lovely fabrics for you as well, and we've had offers on those too that sold out ever so quickly. And what I'm going to show you next door is the 2020. This is your block of the month, and this is all different types of applique. There's hand sewing, there's English paper piecing, there's foundation piecing, there's bargello. There's so many different techniques for you to learn and to enjoy. So you get your main project, you get your second project, you get your block of the month, you have your special offer, you've got your free books, and it doesn't finish there because there's also techniques pages. So there's a whole section of videos on different techniques of dressmaking, how to put a collar on a shirt and cuffs and yokes and fitting a zip and taking up and letting out and full bust adjustment, all of that stuff. It's huge. I do hope you can come and join us. Now then, club started in August 2018, and it just really took off. There's almost 1,500 of you worldwide. And what the lovely thing is, when we do the live Facebook, last Wednesday of the month, 7 o'clock, the people that join are from Philadelphia, from Illinois, from Texas, from South Africa, from Australia, from France, from Spain, from Morocco, Uruguay was a new one at the last chat. And everybody's just coming together and chatting about sewing and what they've done and what they'd like to see. That's what I like. I like the interaction. I like to talk to you. Now then, these chaps are the January main project. So it's the same pattern, different shapes to the noses and the ears. So you can make a teddy bear or you can make the elephant. You could put weights in the bottom and use them as doorstops if you wanted to. I've kept the features really simple on these. So just little dotted beady eyes for the elephant and toy eyes for the teddy bear. But if you wanted to embroider them in the video, I'll show you how to do a French knot. That's entirely up to you. If you wanted to add a nose and a smile or, you know, a little bow, then that's up to you. So when you join, you'll have the pattern, so that's downloadable. You'll have photographic step-by-step instructions, and then you'll have me on a video. So you choose your fabric. You could choose a furry fabric or a fleecy fabric would be lovely and cuddly, wouldn't it? That's entirely up to you, but I'm giving you the basics of how to make them. Oh, this is another one of the techniques. Oh, and the penguin. All of the projects stay on the site for 12 months. Actually, it's a bit longer because we keep forgetting to take them off. So if you go on there now, you'll have access to all of this and more than 12. I must get that sorted. Supposedly stayed there for 12 months, but you know what we're like. And I say we because it's not just me on my own. This is a club that I run in association with Search Press, who are my book publishers. Thus, you'll get 20% discount off anything on their website, including my patterns, including my books, and anybody else's for that matter. And we do lots of giveaways as well. I have Emily, who is my editor. We have Em, who's in charge of marketing. We have Kim, my daughter, who's in charge of me. And we have Caroline, whose idea it was to come up with this club in the first place. So we all work together. So, right, let's get some sewing done. So I've already cut out the pattern pieces. And the funny thing is with this, it looks nothing like an elephant until you start to sew it together. It'll come together, don't worry. So that's, you can tell that's an elephant because that's a trunk. There are some markings that you'll need to transfer. So I've transferred a dot for where the eye is going to go. And then just on the lining side, there's a mark where the top of the ear goes. I haven't put the top and the bottom of the ear because the ears are different shapes for the bear or the elephant. I was just thinking you can make a dog, couldn't you? You can make a rabbit if you did really long loppy ears. So we've got two pieces of the front. And then we've got two pieces for the back. And these are darts as well. Now, although these pieces look a little bit complicated, this has got to be the easiest pattern for a toy if you're a beginner sewer. You could even make it by hand if you're using very small stitches. Because you're not sewing the legs and the arms on separately, the only separate part is the ears. So all the rest of this is all in one, which makes it really easy to sew. So I'm going to sew the darts in first, and the darts give him a bottom. So it'll sit up nice and straight. So that's there. So we've got two darts, and this is at the back. So you'll recognise where they are. Remember, you've got your video for this as well, so don't have to take too much notice now. I always like to use a small length of stitch when I'm sewing toys, because I don't want the stuffing bursting out of them. So, and all of the patterns I use are a quarter of an inch seam allowance, and that's included in the pattern as well. So again, when you get to the end of the dart, a little tip, very gently just curve the dart around, back tack it a little bit, and that means that the dart isn't going to be too pointy. So two back pieces, two front pieces. So I'm going to sew the two back pieces together just around the back of the head and around the body to the bottom here, but I need to leave a turning gap. And I have actually drawn a little mark where my gap's going to be, because I've made quite a few of these toys now and I tend to sew straight over it and forget. Not a problem, that's why you have a quick unpick. So around we go. If you do have requests though, this isn't the kind of club where I sew at you, where I tell you what I'm doing and that's what you've got to do and that's the end of it. It is nice to be interactive, it is nice to have your feedback. So if you have any ideas, if you have any requests, then do come through and let me know. We're working quite a way ahead at the moment because we're looking at Mother's Day in America in May at the moment. But again, if you do have anything particular, like, you know, the man bag or the wheelchair bag, the summer hat was a request actually, that was from last year. So you still have, I know it's a bit small for me, you still have access to the pattern for that one as well. Oh, and the bum bag, the bum bag, carried on sewing while I'm talking. This was a request, but it was a few requests. So the lady who asked me to do a wheelchair bag was also saying that she can't reach the bag. So unless she's got somebody pushing it, she can't reach it. So she wanted a secure bag to go across her front. So she wanted it here, but with a secret pocket on the back. So everything's kind of hidden. Then I had a request for a bag to carry dog treats in, and then one for a bum bag. So this is what I came up with. So it's got one big pocket on the front. There's no dividing pockets inside there, but it does have the secret pocket on the back. So that's going to be against your body if you've got change or you want to keep your phone there. It's got an adjustable strap, which is long enough. If you wanted to wear it crossbody, you can do that. If you wear it over your shoulder, or of course it's a bum bag, you can wear it around your bum. So yeah, that's it. See? You ask and I do my best. And the dressmaking, I like to include lots of techniques. I have had requests for dressmaking patterns, but the problem is when you download a dressmaking pattern, and most of us have got A4 printers, it's an awful lot of paper to stick together. And then there'd have to be all of the different sizes, because you can guarantee that your size will be the one that I missed out. So I've included dressmaking techniques instead of the actual patterns, so that hopefully help you with patterns that you have. So now we're starting to take shape. Now it's starting to look like something. like a toy. On the front, I'm going to do the same again. So this time, I'm going to sew around the top of the head, around the trunk, and all the way around to in between the legs here. So that's the tummy, nose, top of the head. Okay, and that's how the back one's looking at the moment. So you can see there's the bottom, there's the gap that I've left for turning. Oh, do you know what I've got to do before I sew that together? Put his ears on. Read your own instructions, Debbie Shaw. Right. Oh, the fabric, by the way, as well. Forgot to mention the fabric. This is my latest fabric range. It's called New Delhi, and it's inspired by a trip that I made to, funnily enough, New Delhi. I've brought back lots and lots of pictures, lots and lots of fabrics, lots of trimmings, and lots of inspirations. It's been quite a while making up this fabric, designing it. So I start designing, this one was Rukumanaj in January, so I started this about a year ago. And by the time it goes to the designer at Craft Cotton Company, and then she tweaks it, and then we bounce backwards and forwards, so I quite like this and I quite like that. It can take up to a year for this to happen. So I'm just snipping into the curve and show you. Where did I put it? Oh, there we go. Look. Curly-toed shoes. I actually brought back loads of them, suitcase full of curly-toed shoes. I love them. So these are all my drawings of said shoes. This one was inspired by a stained glass window in a museum. The parasols, they're all outside the markets. They're all hand-drawn. These were two fabrics that were lifted again from tiles. We went all over the place. We went to Taj Mahal and everything. This is, I've actually got at home the strips of braiding that I bought, but they were all piled up in the most amazing stores. They're all piled up together. So that's those. And that again is a more neutral colour that was lifted from the stained glass window one. And the spices, the spice market was amazing. And there's ponies, those are ornaments that were hanging up at the airport. So these will be available in most fabric stores, all over the place, all over the world. So I'm really pleased about that. So yeah, all of your big fabric stores, you should be able to find those in there. And if you don't, go and ask them why not. They are all 100% cotton, and they're printed in Korea, which have the highest quality of printing. So pleased. So yeah, the way that works, I come up with some ideas. I'll go along to Vicky, who's a very talented designer at the Craft Cotton Company, and she puts them into a format that's suitable for fabric. And when we're all happy with everything, we get a sample back, just to make sure everything's okay. That's called a strike off. And then it's printed. And then I get all excited. So I've turned this the right side out, and I'm just going to top stitch all the way around the edge. So I do get, I wish things could happen quicker. I get so excited when new ranges or even new books come out. Books take even longer, that can take 18 months. So just edge stitching just to give it a professional finish, but it also helps to keep the ear nice and flat. I haven't put any wadding or anything in this one. And then I'm just going to put a little pleat in the side of the ear just to give it a bit of shape. These are supposed to be floppy ears. So that little pleat just gives them a little bit of flop. So, and don't worry as well, like on this one, the fabric got caught when I was sewing it, and after I sewed the one side, I thought, I actually like that. You see how it's folded back up again? Because it makes it even more floppy. So yeah, I did it on the other one because it just looks so nice. See how things evolve. Don't always turn out as you expected them to. So the ears are going to go right sides together, just over that mark that you've transferred from your pattern. And I'm just sewing that within the seam allowance. And the same on this side. So right sides together, make sure it's the right way up. And again, just sew inside there. I like things that have more than one purpose. Like, it can be an elephant, it can be a bear, it can be a cat, it can be a dog, you can change it for whatever you like. Okay, so let's sew these two pieces together. So this is the bit that goes around the trunk. Again, with that quarter of an inch seam allowance, quite important to have the exact seam allowance on things like this, because pattern pieces are a little bit like jigsaw puzzles. If you have an uneven seam allowance, they might not fit together. But do you know, when I make these up, I come up with an idea and then I get all impatient and cut it out of calico and make it. So no drawing patterns at that stage, I just cut it freehand and make it. I've got some of the most random looking elephants you've ever seen, but then you get attached to them because they're kind of cute. So they never get thrown away. I've got quite a collection. So when I'm happy with the design, where have you gone? There you are, talking to myself. Then I'll draw up a pattern. And the instructions and the step-by-step instructions. So it's a little bit of an odd way of going about things, I think. But then the pattern goes to be digitised by Emma at Search Press. Then it comes back again, and then it's double-checked just to make sure it's right. So I make it up all over again. A lot of work goes into it, doesn't it? I'm going to snip into the curves. So just into the concave curves. And that is going to help the seam to sit flatter. So if you don't snip into the curves, so I'm just going to trim off the corners here as well to cut down on the bulk in the end of the trunk. If you don't cut into the curves, you'll find that the seams pucker a little bit. So I think that's it for that one. And I've just got the back of the neck on the back to do. Let's snip in there. Okay, then we need to sew the both pieces together. So I'll fold the ears out of the way inside the head because I don't want to fold over those. And I'm going to pin this one. So match the seams at the top of the head. And I'm not worried about pressing the seams open, I'm just going to squish them in opposite directions. Have a pin in there. And then the seam at the bottom, so the centre seam of the front with the centre seam of the back. And then I'm going to sew all the way around. Again, just took that ear out of the way. Now, if you want to pin all the way, then you can do. I'm not going to. I just think those two places are really important that they match up. But if you're a new sewer, then maybe you'd like to sew to pin all the way around first of all. It doesn't matter where you start. I like to start across the top of the head, so not from the seam and round, but maybe from one side and then go across, because then you get a smoother line around the top of the head. So there we go. So start with the needle down. And then I can just line up these edges as I go around. There we go. Again, push the ears out of the way as I'm going. Out you go. it would be lovely if you keep in touch. Let me know what you think. Let me know what you think about the Half Yard Club. With the live Facebooks, you can come and watch anyway if you just want to sound us out, see what we like. Ask any questions that you like. We have an Instagram page as well. So take a look at the website. You won't be able to see all of the projects on there straight away, but you'll have an idea of the way that it works. So that's halfyardsewingclub.com. If you want to have a look on our Facebook page, it's again Half Yard Sewing. I've got quite a following on YouTube as well, and there's over 180 videos on there now, with about 220,000 subscribers. So if you want to have a look there, just go onto YouTube and pop in Debbie Shaw, and I should pop up. And in fact, the live Facebooks from the club do go onto the YouTube site. So if you don't do Facebook but you want to see the live Facebooks, they won't be live, but you will be able to see them on YouTube. So, and on Instagram, that wasn't on that page because it's quite new. It's Half Yard Sewing Club. I'm all over the place. So just around the toes here. I try to keep all of the projects really, really simple. I'm very well aware that the majority of people who follow me or buy my books or contact me or that I meet at shows are either new or coming back to sewing. What I'd like you to do is to be able to make something that you're proud of, something that you could sell. You can sell anything, any one of my designs, I don't mind. Or something that you can gift. So although some of the projects may look a little bit complicated, they're not. I explain things very, very clearly. I'm there to help as well. So any member of the club that posts a question or a problem on the Ask a Member page, if a member doesn't reply straight away or if that's aimed at for me, then you will get an answer from that. So I really like to encourage people to sew. It's been a wonderful part of my life, and it's been quite unexpected, to be honest, that I would have a career in sewing. It wasn't what I expected at all. I've always been able to sew because my mum was a seamstress. She used to make wedding dresses and all kinds of things. So there was always sewing going on at home. So I was brought up dressmaking, making clothes for my toys. And then when I grew older, it was curtains and cushion covers and homewares and things like that. But it was never a career, it was always a hobby for me. And my career has been in TV. And in fact, I've been working in television for this year, 41 years. I started working for a shopping channel about 17 years ago. And they started selling sewing machines. I thought, oh, I could do that. I can demonstrate a sewing machine. So I did, and it took off from there. My husband's a photographer. He used to be a fashion photographer. I keep him very busy these days. and he was photographing a cushion cover project that I was making. I said, yeah, blogging was all quite new back in those days. So I'm going back about 12 years. And I said, can you photograph these? And I could set up a blog and I can show people how to do it. When I saw the pictures come through, I thought, I wonder if a publisher would be interested in producing a book with my cushion covers. So I approached Search Press, and they thankfully said yes. My 23rd book comes out next month. I know. And every time a new book comes out, I'm still thinking, pinching myself. And I never, ever dreamed that would happen. So, yes. It's been a wonderful turn of events. And now sewing is what I do. We're almost done here now. Just around the side. Okay, now I've got some more snipping into curves to do. I haven't kind of formally, well, I have kind of formally trained because my mum did a very good job. I studied dressmaking techniques at the London College of Fashion. I've studied upholstery. That's something that I like to do in my spare time as well. But the majority of my knowledge from sewing comes from the mistakes that I've made over the years. So I was the one that sewed my English paper piecing to my skirt. I've sewn sleeves into jackets the wrong way round. Taken them out, re-sewn them back in again, the wrong way round again. So all of those things that you've done when you first start sewing, I've been there, I've done that. But those are the kind of things that I can pass on to you. So snipping into curves, really important. Learned that lesson by not doing it and getting puckered. I'll tell you what else I've done. That's another mistake. Forgot to put the eyes on. See, that's what happens when you're chatting away. I'll put them on now. It's not the end of the world. Lovely floppy ears there. But yeah, those are the things that I can pass on to you. I'm like your mother, aren't I? Right, so let's turn it all the right side out and then I'll put the eyes on. I've got some toy eyes. They recommend with toy eyes that children over four, but have a look at your manufacturer's instructions. So if this is for very young children, you may want to embroider eyes on. Or you can buy applique eyes and sew those on. If you're using buttons, I like to put a bit of glue behind the button just to make sure it doesn't come off. Right, I've got a trunkless elephant. Actually, I never thought this fabric's appropriate, isn't it? It's Indian fabric for an Indian elephant. Right, there we go. Oh, look, he's deflated. So, let's put these eyes in. They're right next to me as well, Adam. Chatting away. So, I left a hole in the middle of the back, remember, for turning it, so I'll just pop these through here. So, tiny hole. And push the eye in. You're better having a small hole that you need to make bigger than a big hole, because you can't make that smaller. And then these have got the backs that clip on. And they're pretty secure. Normally once they're on, they don't go anywhere. I like the eyes tiny and close together, because I just think it looks really cute. But again, if you wanted to put big eyes on there, then you do what you like. It's the same for most of the projects that I bring you in the club, actually. So if you see maybe a quilt that you want to make bigger, or you think, I don't want to make a full-size quilt, I want to make a bag, then you've got the opportunity to do that. You don't have to follow everything the way that I say. Right, so put those there. Now, the one that comes to stuffing, I like to stuff a little bit at a time. Certainly in areas like the trunk. You'll find if you push in a big lump of stuffing right up to the end of the trunk, it gets knotted and it pulls away from the end. If you put tiny little pieces in, it'll stay in place a lot better. So that was a lesson learnt. So tiny little bits. Only in the extremities. So don't worry about putting tiny little bits all the way through the body, but certainly in the trunk and the arms and legs, then do that. So, and it'll stay there. I shan't do all of it. Just give you an idea of what it's going to look like. You could put something fragranced in there as well, maybe a little bit of lavender. That'd be nice for a child at bedtime, wouldn't it? Then just keep going. Now when it comes to sewing up the hole at the back, I've used a ladder stitch. I'm just trying to find the neatest one to show you. The smaller the gap that you leave, the less hand stitching that you're going to have to do. Probably won't have time in this hour to get around to the hand stitching, but basically you're going to go across, down, across, down, across, down, across, down, across, down, and then gently pull. This is all in the video. I do get that far in the video, but it'll leave you the stitches that are going across the opening this way, which is why it's called a ladder stitch. And it's the most invisible stitch that you can use. So that's the stitch that you're going to use if you've got a split in a garment or something like that, and you just want to make it look like a machine sewn seam, but do it by hand. Okay. Oh, I've got some testimonials to read you as well from the club. Shall I do that while I'm stuffing? Not the most interesting thing, what do you mean? Stuff an elephant, is it? Mary said, love it, it's a friendly place and there are no stupid questions. Don't mind stupid questions, to be honest. Tina says, very friendly group, inspirational projects and guidance from Debbie makes it more fun to do. Angie says, these are all on Facebook, so you can have a look at them. There's loads on there. I follow Debbie from the very beginning. I have every book, DVD and video, as well as all of her kits and dyes. I'd not really done any sewing until I found Debbie Shaw. She's inspired me and encouraged me, even though I make things that put me out of my comfort zone. I've got my daughter hooked now. See, this is what I love. It's the best part of the job. I say that so often, is the feedback that I get from you. Particularly if you thought I'd never be able to do that, and then you do it. I mean, perhaps just imagine how satisfying that will be. Maggie says, this group is excellent for anyone from beginners to the advanced sewing enthusiast. Loads of help and support from other members. She's actually put loads of Yelp, but I think it's supposed to be help. And of course, Debbie is at hand for any questions. Certainly am, not going anywhere. Alison says, I just love this concept. I joined today. The webpage was so fresh and inspiring. I love Debbie, and even though I'm a late starter to the sewing world, she's given me the confidence in her videos to give things a go. I can't wait to start this journey with her and fellow members. Well done, Debbie. Thank you. And Maureen says, it has something for everyone and anyone who likes sewing, a lovely, friendly group. We're a nice bunch, if I say so myself. And Sally says, it's a great place to learn and to show off your latest makes as well. And Mary says, I love Debbie's videos and books. I'm a beginner and her details, easy explanation has helped me create some lovely things. Thanks, Debbie. Love that feedback. Go on Facebook and take a look yourself. There's lots of them on there. I'm very happy as well for any of my designs if you want to sell them. And I know a lot of you do. So don't worry about asking permission or anything like that. Please don't just print off the patterns and sell those. But if you want to make anything from the patterns and take them along to a craft fair or sell to friends and family, then absolutely, you do that. The way I'm thinking is, if you can make the money that you spend with me back again by selling what you've made, you're more likely to come back for more. And I'd want to do that as well. That's how we're looking so far. Isn't he cute? I like to keep the head quite firm. I'll keep the neck quite firm as well, but don't put too much stuffing into the legs and arms, because that's quite nice when he's cuddly. So enough to keep the head firm and the neck rigid, but just keep his legs a little bit floppy. I've got a bag to show you as well, because another thing that I've been working on are some patterns for Bosal, and they're a little bit different. But can I take you back through again and give you the details about the club, and then I'll come back and we'll do a little bit of bag making. So, it's the Halfyard Sewing Club. Oh, we need a jingle, don't we? It's the Halfyard Sewing Club.com. We've got the, that's the website address. Then you've got the Facebook is Halfyard Sewing Club. And if you want to look for me on YouTube, then just type in Debbie Shaw. And Instagram, which is all very new, is Halfyard Sewing Club. So if you just joined us, hello. These are just a small selection of some of the projects that I bring you from the Halfyard Sewing Club. It's a subscription website. I haven't even told you how much, have I? It's £5.99 a month. So for the price of a couple of cup of coffees, you can have a project with a video, with a downloadable pattern, and with downloadable step-by-step instructions. No physical products are sent out, because this is a worldwide club. We've got members all over the world, and the shipping would just be so expensive. So it makes it more accessible to everybody. So one main project, that could be the man bag. It could be a satchel. It could be, I'll tell you what I haven't shown you. It could be a sewing machine dust cover. which I explain in the video how to measure your sewing machine. It's all fully lined and everything. So you've got the perfect fit, the applique shape is there, and there's instructions on how to make a sewing machine mat to match as well. That's one of your main projects. Main projects are, oh, the overnight bag. I've made this up in faux leather as well. That's quite a nice sizable bag. If you're new to sewing, then maybe leave the piping off. I explain that in the video. It could be the kitchen set, again with applique. I try and involve lots of different techniques that you can then use on other projects as well. So you saw the black and white table runner. I also made one into a bag. You don't have to follow my instructions exactly. This is the Japanese folded technique. It's more about learning the technique. So this is a small selection. So you can either go for $5.99 a month. If you're watching over in the States, it's $9.95. If you wanted to pay for a whole year, that's £60 if you're in the UK, or it's $99 if you're in the US. But this is worldwide, so we'll translate whatever currency that you're in. If you subscribe for a whole year in one go, then you will you get 2 months free, basically. But anybody that joins up with the club today, you're going to have a month for free. You'll be able to see everything that we have for you, all of the different projects for you for at least the last 12 months. And if you pop into the, when you go through to register all your details, if you put into the coupon code SQDebbie in capital letters, I will send you a half yard vintage book absolutely free of charge. That's just for registering right now. So one main project. But you've also got another project that doesn't have a video, so you're getting two projects a month. Then there's the block of the month. I'll show you that again in just a second. So that's three projects. Block of the month's ongoing, obviously, for 12 months. You will have discounts. So any of my books on the Search Press website, I've got a pattern page on the website as well. You as a member will receive 20% discount. So on the bag that I'm going to show in just a second, you receive 20% discount on the patterns there. And on anybody else's book from Search Press as well. And over the last 12 months, in prizes and giveaways and competitions and just thank yous, we've given away over 100 products for you as well. We did a 12 days of Christmas last month. So for 12 days, one person each day received something that I'd made. There was a smock cushion, there was a small quilt, there was a soft toy, can't remember what else, there must have been bags in there somewhere. So you can see that it's absolutely jam-packed full of inspiration, of ideas, and lots of different things for you to learn as well. There's techniques page, so you can learn, there's videos all about dressmaking, just been filming one about chain piecing, so patchwork techniques going on there as well. And we're building on this every single month. So I promised you block of the month, didn't I? Let me show you the block of the month. This is this year's block of the month. This launches in the beginning of January, so the first block is actually the flying geese, which is around the edge. So there's 11 physical blocks, and then the 12th, or the first one, is the flying geese. So lots and lots of different techniques. This is a quilt that I designed alongside my very good quilting friend, Melissa Naylor. And we've put together lots of different applique techniques. I think you'll agree, it's just amazing. And we're going to be giving you details if you've got any left, special offers on the fabrics that have been used as well. But you can use any fabric that you like, you don't have to stick to those colourways. So, just got time to show you how the patterns work. So these are, bear with me, I should be back in a second. These are my three bags. These are my two bags. One of them is also called Rosemary. Forgot that one. And the way that they work is with Bosal foam stabiliser. A lot of you will have these already. You have been sending me pictures. And I love to see your pictures. If you want to go on a Facebook page and put some pictures of your bags on there, I would love to see them. But they work actually with Bosal pre-cut shapes. You don't have to have the pre-cut shapes. So if these aren't available anymore, then you can just use the pattern. But the pattern is used with the Bosal, not with the fabric. So I've already cut these out because I just wanted to show you the technique. You two go over there and behave. So I've already cut, these are the pre-cut shapes, but you cut out your Bosal shape and then place that over the top of your fabric. and then you're going to cut the fabric out about half an inch wider all the way around. That's the satchel that you're going to be able to make. So I've used a magnetic buckle. You could use a magnetic snap if you wanted to. I keep my bubble wrap in here. So they've got lots of uses. So you don't have to have the pocket on the front. If you wanted to make the strap adjustable, then you can do. I'm giving you the skeleton, if you like, the basics of what to do. So we'll take our scissors. It's always scissors that I lose. I don't move very far when I'm sewing, but it's always the scissors that I can't find. And then cut half an inch all the way around. When you've cut, you're going to sew up against the bowsaw, so it makes it so easy to get an absolutely perfect shape. And then the lining pieces, you'll use this cutout piece as a template. Now, because I was saying earlier, I do like to encourage new people to have a go at sewing, and you may look at a satchel and think, no, that's just too challenging for me. If you have a smartphone or a tablet and you download a QR code reader, there is actually a video tutorial that gives you, well, in real time, sewing together the whole bag. That's on the instructions inside the packet. So that's that. That's the gusset that I've already cut out. And this is the front of the bag. So again, just not particularly accurately really with this, but around about a half inch or a centimetre. So how many of you got sewing machines for Christmas? These are perfect projects for somebody that's wanting to trial out your new sewing machine, because it's foolproof. You can't go wrong when you're using these bowsaw shapes. So yeah, I'm not going to do the lining now because I just want to show you the way that the foam works, because I know we're running out of time. So that's the front. That is the back end, the flap. Your fastener will go on the front here. So depending on what you're going to use, you could use a magnetic buckle if you can find them, or a button with a ribbon around. You know, there's lots of different ways that you can fasten it. That's up to you. And this is the gusset that goes around here like so. So let's pin these together. Or you can use your clover clips if you wish. And I can feel where the foam is. So I need to line the foam up against the foam. So I'm not worried about the edge of the fabric, it's the foam. So let's have, oh, clips. And again, I'm just feeling my way around. I know that needs to be on that side, so we'll do this bit next. So I can feel that the foam is meeting. And they were so up against the foam. So it's actually really easy. It's worth taking your time in this section just to get these lined up perfectly. So I'll tell you what makes it easier. Snip into the curve at this point. That's a little extra for you. That's not in the instructions, but it makes it easier. You learn something new every time you make something, don't you? And I'm still getting feedback from people at home saying, "Oh, can you, have you tried this? Have you tried that?" Janet sent me a message a few weeks ago, and she was saying when she's creasing fabric, she runs it over the edge of the table and does that with it, and you get a lovely crease. Never thought about that. Okay, we'll just have one at the bottom and then we'll sew. So no seam allowance to worry about with this. I'm going to sew right up against the edge of the foam. So here we go. I don't need a special foot. I don't need a walking foot because the foam squishes down really flat. And I'm just literally taking the needle right up to the edge of the foam. Don't worry if you catch the foam slightly. It won't make that much of a difference. But as a guide to sew against, it is absolutely foolproof. You can't go wrong with it. You're not going to get a wobbly seam. So I'm going to line those up. The rosemary bag has a scalloped front to it, flap to it. I'll show you that in just a second. That can be a little bit tricky to sew around scallops, getting all of them absolutely perfectly uniform. But this technique, as I said, it's foolproof. There you go. And it gives a nice structure as well. You could use a fusible fleece instead of the foam, but you'd have a floppy bag. This foam will give you a little bit of rigidity, but still making it easy to sew. So it's perfect. Okay, coming up to the next curve. Again, just lining up I'm feeling my way around, just feeling that foam. Now with the patterns, these are on the Search Press website. Not the foam, but the patterns are on there. And remember, as a club member, you'll get 20% discount. So it's well worth joining, even if it's just to make a few purchases. And that's of any Search Press product. So apologies to any other authors. I'm giving my club members 20% off your book. Right, and then we're back up to the top. And then when we turn this the right side out, you've got the perfect curve. Because you can't go wrong with it, look at that. So both of them symmetrical, both of them absolutely perfect, and you saw how quick and easy that was as well. Ooh. So I thought I'd missed a bit, but it was the print. So there you are, looking really closely, I've got a hole in it. So the flap will go on, the front will go on the back in the same way, so that's sewn on right sides together, like so. And then when you turn it the right side out, that's going to be the outside of your bag. With the fabric on the back, try and make it a non-directional fabric like my ponies, because if you have a fabric in one direction and you fold it in half for the flap, then it's going to be upside down on one side or the other. So the only other thing to do there, if you wanted a particular directional print, is to sew the two pieces of fabric together, cut it in half, turn it around so that they're mirror imaged, and then sew them together across the top, and then put your bosal pattern on and then cut it out. So that's the way that works. Your straps go on the side here. Drop the lining inside and then sew around the top, and you've got a fabulous bag. Let me show you that rosemary bag as well, because again, it's not just the bag, it's the fabric. So this one's rosemary. Now I've added an embellishment. I brought these back from India as well, and a chain strap on there. On the pattern, I'll show you how to put a wide strap, and it goes into the back of the bag just here. But I just thought a chain on that would look really pretty and gives it a little bit more of an evening look. So that's the rosemary bag. And then this one is the Elizabeth. So this is a shopper. This is quite a roomy bag, as you can see. But again, if you want to put pockets on there, maybe a zip pocket on the inside, then that's very simple to do as well. Okay, let me give you a reminder of my club and all of the things that you can make when you join. So the address is thehalfyardsewingclub.com. That's our website address. I say we because it's not just me. There's about six of us working on this at the moment. I try to bring you every single month something different, something where you can learn a new technique, something that you can expand your sewing knowledge with. So you're going to find a little bit of patchwork, you'll have some quilting, you've got homewares, we've got table runners, we've got those cushion covers, there was an advent calendar last year with a plique with robins on it. You've got the man bag, the wheelchair bag, the overnight bag, the little character drawstring bags. Do you know one of my favourite characters is Birthday Bear? So this is Birthday Bear. But then, I think it was in one of the live Facebooks, I showed you how to upsize birthday bear to make a huge bear. So he's got birthday bear family. I think he's so funny. There's little dotty eyes again. It could be homewares such as oven gloves, and those are the appliques with the coffee, the mug, the coffee mug, the coffee cup, the coffee jug. What do they call them? That's a mug hug. We'll call it a jug hug. That'll do. I think it's a cafetiere cover, but I like jug hug. It sounds better. This is a little evening bag in the shape of a pair of lips. This is one of the secondary projects. So one project every single month with a video and with step-by-step instructions and photographic instructions and a downloadable pattern as well. I want you to feel part of this community. I love the feedback from and I love the interaction of the club. It isn't just something where every month we send you something and that's what you're going to make and that's it. It's a build-up of resources, of tips and techniques. There's lots of videos, there's lots of pages to download. There's lots of extra projects on there as well. There's lots of competitions. There's always some kind of competition going on, or giveaways, or offers on fabrics, on books, on patterns. There's always something happening on that website. And I know that the almost 1,500 members that we have there enjoy it so much because you do communicate, you do interact. You come through on Facebook, you send me messages on the website as well, and it's so lovely to hear from you. We've got lots of different skill levels. So if you are an absolute expert sewer, I like to take inspiration from other people. I may not follow the instructions to make that wonky-eyed penguin all the way through exactly, but I may tweak it a little bit. Oh, I think your scarf's coming off, isn't it? So you take ideas. You may take the messenger bag and think, no, I want to put another pocket. I'll put a pocket on the front. I want a hidden pocket on the flap there. I don't want to fasten it this way. I might make it a little bit deeper. So even for more experienced sewers, there's going to be something that can inspire you to get your mojo back if you don't know what to sew. So if you join now, and quote SQ Debbie in capital letters, I'll send you a book as well, just for joining up. And you'll have access to a back catalogue of 12 months at least worth of projects. And remember, that's at least two a month. So you've got 24 projects for your first payment of £5.99. You can unsubscribe at any time that you want to as well. We don't tie you in for a whole year. There's no contract or anything like that. If you're not happy after the first one, then off you go. That's absolutely fine. Well, it's not. Rather you stayed, but but that is an option for you as well. I hope you've enjoyed the tutorial. I hope you've enjoyed seeing how the bags are put together. The next thing I'd just like to say is that I'd love you to join me on halfyardsewingclub.com. I'll see you again there. Bye-bye.